And we're talking about Naomi Long's success and stuff like that. So I'd like to know what your party is doing, both your parties are doing, to get more women and young women involved in politics.
Well, I don't see it like that. I don't think it's a matter of attracting more women or particular groups. I mean, I think that a party's appeal should be on its principles and on the matters of substance. And if those matters of substance are sufficiently meaningful, it will attract, you know, women and men and younger people. I totally take issue with this kind of liberal notion that we're all having to specifically have our own little diversity agendas. I don't believe in that. I believe in principle and in substance, and those are the matters that I stick with. And you get with some ludicrous things, such as the all-women shortlist, for example, that we've seen in the UK. Again, I mean, that's reverse sexism as far as I'm concerned. So, no, people should be judged on their individual merits. It doesn't matter what they are. They should be judged on individual merits. Liberal parties should have their clear, substantive principles.
Well, that would appear to be an entirely valid point if we were starting from a neutral neutral starting point, but it is undeniable that in the history of politics, particularly British politics, with a few extremely notable exceptions, women have been in the extreme minority. It's really quite important for parties who kind of, not so much preach, but kind of advocate impartiality, that in order to be properly impartial, efforts are going to have to be trying
to... Why? I don't know the point. Tell me why.
I'll tell you why. It's actually quite embarrassing to be sitting here listening to someone say that there isn't a need to provide means to attract more women, say, into politics, when there's a clear underrepresentation of women in politics, which means that our politicians don't reflect our society at large, which means that society at large isn't getting a fair distribution of what it should be. There's an underrepresentation of women in politics. Now, there are real reasons for that. Women generally, not exclusively, but generally are the primary carers of children. So childcare is a massive issue with reasons why women don't get involved in politics, because...
Do men not care about children?
Of course they do, but primarily women, and that's just, you know, that's not exclusively, but primarily women are the primary carers.
Quite done.
Because that's the way it is. Because that's the way...
It's reality, isn't it?
Yeah, because that's...
So what's your problem with reality?
Because that's the way men have made the law.
What's men?
Yeah. That's
the men are to blame.
No, men aren't to blame, but there's an absolute need, and not just women, there's an absolute need to address the underrepresentation of women, ethnic minorities, those of different sexual orientation, and all the other diversities that exist in our society. There's an absolute need to address that.
I think it's very, very interesting, and to perhaps jump in kind of in a slightly, slightly awkward way, to look at perhaps the leading women in Northern Ireland politics, for instance, Margaret Ritchie. Margaret Ritchie has come out and said that in a career in politics, she feels that she has no time for men. In very high-profile interviews, it's interesting, and nothing against that choice. I mean, if she has the interest of starting a family, I feel that she should be given that time. But it's important that everyone is represented, and you know, mothers, child carers, women in whatever kind of walk of life they choose to be, have the right kind of inherently to be represented. And the fact is that with reality, indeed, they may not have the time, which means that perhaps there should be kind of particular effort given it ostensibly looks unfair, ostensibly looks biased, reverse sexism, but in order for there to be an accurate and a fair representation in politics, do you not think that there should be some kind of...
Well, I think you have to define things fair as well.
It's called affirmative action, and it is fair.
It's called liberalism.
No, it's called affirmative action, and it is fair. Sorry, if there is an issue with underrepresentation, it needs to be addressed.
Why shouldn't it be addressed?
Well, why should men be the majority? White men be the majority, the overwhelming majority? Why should they be disproportionately represented in politics? You tell me a good reason why that should be the case.
Well, first of all, I wasn't aware I was here to answer your question.
Yeah, but I've asked your question.
Seeing as how you have an answer in a second. But in the first instance, I believe in the radical view that the best person should get the job, you think.
And you don't believe that. Sorry, just to interrupt. You don't believe there are some barriers. There are some barriers for certain types of people.
Are you saying that the best people to get the job are men?
So one question at a time. Please don't cut across me when I'm talking, right? Okay, if you'd like to repeat the question, yes. And I can hear it this time, I'll try and answer it.
Well, no, you said before about you know, that it should be your worth and your merit that gets you your position. So are you saying that, A, your party isn't doing anything to involve more women, which, you know, that, so that they're not for equality of the sexes in your party, and B, that the way it kind of sounds was that the best person should get the job, which kind of implies that it's in a men that submits the best person for the job to man.
So, so